Welcome back, troglodytes, to Would You Rock or Not? This guitar gets sent to me on a daily basis as a suggestion for the show, so I figured, hey, we might as well cover it. This is what appears to be a highly modified Les Paul that the seller is claiming it's from 1979. Now, I'm not quite sold on that because this guitar does not have the specs of a 1979 Les Paul. It could actually be an earlier one than that. So let's take a look here. Why can this not be a 79? Well, first you have an ABR1 bridge right here. The ABR1 bridge kind of got phased out for a while around 1975 when Gibson was moving to the Nashville factory. That's when they started using the Nashville style bridge. Now it's possible that this bridge is just sitting on a conversion post, but it's not able to be determined from these photos. Next up, this guitar appears to have a mahogany neck. This is the only photo that shows the neck at all, and a mahogany neck would not be on a 79 Les Paul. Maple necks also started around the same time as the switch to the Nashville-styled bridge. So if this was actually a Gibson guitar, I would say this is more so likely an early 70s Les Paul Deluxe that has been routed for humbuckers. However, there's one key feature missing from this guitar, and that's a pancake body. If this was an early 70s Les Paul Deluxe, it would have a mahogany maple mahogany sandwich right here, and you would be able to see it very clearly. Now, this body has definitely been slimmed down a lot, but it doesn't appear that half of it is missing or anything crazy like that. Something else that goes against this guitar being an early 70s Deluxe is there's no volute on the back of the headstock. Now, since it's been repaired and refinished, it's possible that was just sanded off. However, I'm gonna go out on a limb and say this isn't actually a Gibson guitar. If we take a look at the headstock here, obviously it's been heavily modified, but this shape isn't even quite correct for a Gibson headstock. This one more so looks like an L6S headstock. It kind of has this slantedness to it. This Gibson logo definitely does not look original to this guitar. Now, the toggle switch cavity is really strange. However, that can be easily explained. The area where you can see that epoxy is likely the end of the original route. So when they did the extra contouring to the body, they had to redesign that cavity route. So I'm guessing this is probably one of the lawsuit era Les Pauls that has been modified later on in life and been rebranded as a Gibson, but let's go ahead and look at all these modifications. If this did start life as a Les Paul, a second cutaway has been added. It looks like you have an aftermarket pickguard on here and Seymour Duncan pickups. The headstock has definitely been chopped up a lot and the tuners have been moved. And the body has been given rounded edges to it. Now personally, I think this guitar would probably actually play really well. However, based on the seller's photos, I don't think I could actually advertise this guitar as a Gibson. However, this guitar does look fairly good, so let's play devil's advocate and say it is a real Gibson. What information would I need to further identify this thing? I would need further photos of the serial number that they're thinking that they can see. I would want to see the pickup cavity routes as well as the control cavity routes. I mean, it is entirely possible that this could be like a late 60s Les Paul, because that is pretty much the only thing that these specs would closely match. Since the serial number is kind of done in the 60s style, if the seller is missing the first digit because they think it's 14732, but if they're missing a leading 5, it is possible this could be a 1968 Les Paul that was just horribly butchered. That is pretty much the only guitar that I think this could be if it was a real Gibson at one point in time. So in the end, I really don't have an answer for this one. I did reach out to the seller for additional photos, so maybe they will provide that and we can find out one day. What do you think this guitar is? The only question left, Would you rock this mystery Les Paul or not? Leave your answer down in the comment section below, and we will see you tomorrow on the next episode. Take care.